بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه والسلام تسليما كثيرا. There's a guy, a Shia guy, he made a video claiming that he's exposing Shamsi because of a video that I made a long time ago about exposing Shia claim that there is Ali, he's the Khalifa after Prophet Sallam. And after I mentioned the Hadith in Sahih Bukhari, which clear cut a refutation against them, that Ali is what? Is a Khalifa. That when Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib said to Ali ibn Abi Talib, before Prophet ﷺ died, few days way after the event of Ghadir Khum, because the Shia always use the event of Ghadir Khum, Na'am, Allah man wali man wala, Aliyul Mawla, Na'am, the Hadith, that is a proof that Ali is Khalifa. But I use the Hadith in Bukhari, which clear cuts the refutation against them. And that was Hadith, Alhamdulillah, but Allah's Tawfiq was Qasimatul Dahr, it was a bug. Striker for them. So he went and he said, no, there is a hadith in Sunnah ibn Abi Asim that Prophet said, Ali is Khalifa after me. And he put up in his channel someone who is well known in the Arab world. Kamal al-Haydari is known to be Kaddab, is known, Ma'roof, to be Kaddab. One of the proofs here, what? Forgive us this, I don't know, what's this, to be honest?
للإمام أبي بكر أحمد بن أبي عاصم المتوفى 287 من الهجرة حققه وخرج أحاديثه الأستاذ الدكتور الجوابرة أستاذ الحديث بجامعة الإمام محمد بن سعود دار الصميعي الجزء الثاني صفحة 799 الرواية قال رسول الله لعلي أنت مني بمنزلة هارون من موسى إلا أنك لست نبيا وأنت خليفتي في كل مؤمن من بعدي يقول إسناده حسن رجاله رجال الشيخين ولكن يقول هذه من أباطيل الشيعة
لا إله إلا الله
كتاب السنة لابن أبي عاصم للحافظ ابن أبي عاصم الشيباني المتوفى كذا بتحقيق الألباني في صفحة 560 في الحديث 1188 أنت مني بمنزلة هارون موسى إلا أنك لست نبيا إلا أنه لا ينبغي أن أذهب إلا وأنت خليفتي في كل مؤمن من بعدي إسناده حسن ورجاله ثقات رجال الشيخين
وهنا يقول لا بوجه من الوجوه لا يصح
هو باطل
لا إله إلا الله
So what he did, he used Kamal al-Haydari, al-Haydari al-Kaddab. Kamal al-Haydari, he's reading from a book, Sunnah ibn Abi Asim, by one doctor called al-Jawabira, and by Imam al-Albani, may Allah have mercy upon him. But what he didn't notice, he did, because he explained after about one of the narrators in the hadith, in a chair of narration, is considered to be da'if. You see, there is the scholars differ concerning him, the scholars of hadith. So, Kamal al-Haydari, what he did, instead of finishing, let me read Kamal al-Albani. Kamal al-Albani here, he said, Isnadu Hassan. This you can download it. The book is on, you can get the book on PDF online. So he said, the hadith, which is, Anta bi manzilati Harun. This hadith is talking about specific matter, specific event, which is the Ghazwa Tabuk. When the Messenger of Allah left to go to Tabuk to fight against the Romans, he said, no one should be left after me. I'm no one. All the people should come with me from the Rijal. Yes? So he appointed Ali to be in charge after women, a lot of them were just women and children in Medina. That's why Narish ibn Abi Talib was crying. Prophet said, would you not be happy to be like Moses and Harun, Musa and Harun? However, there's no prophet after me. You see, so Prophet is given this similitude here that Harun was in charge after Bani Israel, after Musa alayhi left. But that similitude is not similar between Musa and Harun and Prophet and Ali from every angle. Because when Musa alayhi left, Harun was looking after the kibar, the major companions of Musa alayhi salam. As Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned, this expression of Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy upon him. However, when Prophet left Ali in charge, that was the similitude. But, Harun was left in charge, Ali was left in charge. Radiallahu anhu, Ali and Musa. نعم. But left Ali in charge of women and children. That's why I was crying. So that hadith similitude here of leaving you in charge. Okay? So that was specific matter and a specific matter. Not a general, not your khalifa after me. Because we know Prophet many times left Medina when he went to fight against the Arab pagans. And he left Ibn Maktoum and left another sahaba to be in charge in Medina of the after Prophet Muhammad in Medina. However, let us go to the hadith. So the kadhab, Kamal al-Haydari, what he did, he said, Isnaduhu Hasan, wa rijaluhu thiqat, rijalu shaykhain. Stopped. He say, see? And Miskin, the representative of the program, he say, look. And they say, it's battle. But akmil ya kadhab. Finish the channel. Finish kalam al-Imam al-Albani. Ghayr, except. So all the narrators in that chain of narration of this hadith, all of them are thiqat, trustworthy. And they are the men of Bukhari and Muslim. Except Abi Balj. نعم اسمه يحيى بن سليم بن بلج قال الحافظ صدوق ربما أخطأ بس الإمام الألباني finished now الإمام الألباني's كلام however كمل الحيدة never finished it but الحمد لله بإذن الله we are here to expose your lies against أهل السنة والجماعة so he said الحافظ now الإمام الألباني is quoting الحافظ نعم said صدوق is truthful but he has mistakes. Okay, now that's from Ibn al-Albani, tahqiq. Now we go to the other tahqiq, which is the tahqiq of Jawabra. Jawabra said, again the same hadith, نعم, وتخليفتي في كل مؤمن بعدي. He said, إسناده حسن. The إسناد of this hadith is حسن, sound. رجاله رجال الشيخين. And the man of this hadith, رجال, man of الشيخين. غير, again, كما الحيدة never carried on, he stopped. And he said, see, and they said, his hadith is batil. But carry on, ya kadhab. Why are you lying? He's known to be lying. You know, he's known to be a liar. Anyway, alhamdulillah. You know, he had to, by the way, remember, he's claiming that he's going to expose me. He was exposing me. Subhanallah. Inshallah. La hawla la quwwata illa billah. Alhamdulillah, that's tawfiq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, yes, man of Shaykhain, غير Abi Balj. نعم اسمه يحيى بن سليم بن بلج قال الحافظ صدوق ربما أخطأ الحافظ said is it truthful but he made mistakes وله شواهد however there's the other narrations as a witness نعم there's other narration as a witness the narration that is referring to is way back however many scholars said on that narration there's a lot of things which go clear against the hadith which is a Bukhari Muslim so Abu Balj the man used تحقيق of أحمد شاكر. أحمد شاكر said المسند in تحقيق المسند he said البخاري said أبو بلج فيه نظر. However, I couldn't find it where. No, he did. البخاري said أحمد شاكر is a عالم, a big scholar without any doubt. But not الشمسي. الحمد لله. I know my limits, but Allah's توفيق. Not me saying that. إمام مقبل من هذه الوادعي رحمه الله تعالى سنة. نعم أنا book I believe in the كتاب المزي نعم الإمام المزي ما شنده نعم الكامل المزي I believe نعم anyway here الإمام أبو الهادي وادع السيد أبو بلج so in this narration أبو بلج is ضعيف there is قول نعم أبو بخاري فيه نظر let us read out what إمام مقبل بن هادي الوادعي one of the علماء الحديث نعم great of one of the great علماء الحديث may Allah have mercy upon him said about أبو بلج So Imam Muqbil bin Hadi Wadi'i said, Imam Muqbil has a book called تتبعات الأوهام الحاكم التي سكت عنها الذهبي. نعم, the mistakes that Hakim fell into, which Imam al-Dhahabi went silent about it, yes? Because Imam al-Dhahabi done checking of Mustadrak, however, not in everything. So Imam Muqbil said, رحمه وتعالى, نعم, رفعت الحديث, إذا حديث صحيح, قال لا, said no أبو بلج يحيى بن سليم ويقال ابن أبي سليم مختلف فيه العلماء differ concerning him والراجح ضعفة and the strongest opinion that is ضعيف he's what ضعيف إذا الجرح فيه مفسر he said why because the criticism on him is detailed so we take it yes we take it. البخاري statement فيه نظر وهي من أردى عبارات التشريع عند البخاري. When البخاري says someone فيه نظر, when the statement is one of the most severe statement of criticism, then you say, look, again, you just proving my point. But alhamdulillah, that's not because me. That's from the tawfiq of Allah Jalla wa Ala to expose your lie against Ahl al-Sunnah, and that you are people who are calling people to worship Qubur and calling people to the way of misguidance, okay? Because we love Ali ibn Abi Talib, but we don't raise him above his station. Likewise, we love Jesus, we don't raise him above his station. So here is da'if. For the sake of argument, as Imam al-Bani rahmatullahi explained, he said this hadith is speaking about a specific matter, which is Ghazwat Tabuk. He's not speaking about all the time, because the fact that we know many times Prophet ﷺ left Medina and he never left Ali as a Khalifa after the people there. Rather, there was many times Prophet ﷺ left Medina and Ali left with him, and he left one of the great Sahabas behind him. However, he appointed someone else to be in charge of them. But Ghazwat Tabuk, Prophet ﷺ left, no one left behind except women and children and old people who had excuse to not go fight. So that is a clear, that's one thing. Then he goes to try to criticize the hadith which has been mentioned in Bukhari. So he said the Zuhri, rahimahu ta'ala, it was known to take money from Dawla al-Umawiyya, and he mentioned one narration about him. But we know that the A'imma, you go see Alam al-Nubala, Imam al-Dhahabi mentioned, he said one of the ulama of Sunnah, one of the Hufad of hadith, the Abdul Scholars agreed on him. Taking money from the Umayyad, there is no problem with that. We know that Al-Hasan used to take the money from Zayd, from Yazid. Al-Hasan, likewise, used to take the money from Mu'awiyah ibn Sufyan, who are the Umayyad. So therefore, we should not trust Hasan according to him, because he used to take the money from them. However, now, let us see if Imam al-Zuhri used to narrate a hadith in favor of the Umayyad. Let us see that. Ibn Asakir. نعم نعم ابن عساكر منشن إن التاريخ likewise الذهبي في السير نعم الشافعي ساد حدثني عمي قال دخل سليمان بن يسار على هشام بن عبد الملك فقال يا سليمان من الذي تولى كبره منهم قال عبد الله بن أبي بن سلول قال كذبت هو علي بن أبي طالب قال أمير المؤمنين أعلم بما يقول فدخل ابن شهاب الزهري فسأله هشام فقال هو عبد الله بن أبي بن سلول قال كذبت هو علي بن أبي طالب فقال له أنا أكذب لا أبى لك لا أبى لك فوالله لو نادى منادي من السماء أن الله أحل الكذب ما كذبت. Look, الله أكبر. This narration is a back striker for Rafida against lying against Zuhri. Zuhri entered, one of the narrators entered upon one of the Khulafa here, which is Sulaiman. نعم. No, he's sorry, Shah ibn Abd al-Malik. So Sulaiman ibn Yasar, نعم, entered upon Shah ibn Abd al-Malik. And the verse about the one who referred to Abdullah ibn Abi Salul, this verse basically, he was referring to Abdullah ibn Abi Salul, but Shah ibn Abd al-Malik said, no, it was about Ali ibn Abi Talib. So Yasir ibn Malik, or Yasir ibn Sulaiman ibn Yasar, he went silent, said, you have more knowledge than me. نعم. أنت أعلم. نعم. Then suddenly Zuhri enter and he asked same question Zuhri. Zuhri said, no, it was about Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, not Ali ibn Abi Talib. He said, you're lying. He said, woe to you, you call me a liar. He said, but Allah, if Allah calls out, or someone like Malik or Allah subhanahu calls out from the heaven, say it's permissible to lie or not lie. نعم. مباح من you're allowed to lie, no problem. He said, I will not lie. نعم. And you go against Zuhri. He said he used to look, he stood like a man against Umawi, Hisham ibn Abd al-Malik, defending who? Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu arda. Let alone this Kitab al-Tabaqat, Ulama al-Hadith, نعم, ibn Abd al-Hadi, may Allah have mercy upon him. And here he speaks about Zuhri. نعم, Zuhri. Look what he said, ibn Abd al-Hadi, Alam. علم الحفاظ أبو بكر محمد بن مسلم بن عبيد الله بن عبد الله بن شهاب بن عبد الله بن الحارث بن زهرة بن كلاب القرشي الزهري المدني الإمام ولد سنة 50. So then he called him علم الحفاظ, a sign of حفظ, of memorization. نعم, he was إمام. So Look what Amr ibn Dinar said about Zuhri. He said, مَا رَأَيْتُ الدِّنَارَ وَالدِّرْهَمَ عِنْدَ أَحَدْ أَهْوَنُ مِنْهُ عِنْدَ الزُّهْرِ كَأَنَّهُ بِمَنْزِلَةِ الْبَعْرِ. Allahu Akbar. Amr ibn Dinar said, I never see someone belittle money the way Imam Zuhri do it. نعم. As if those the money, dirham and dinar, is like just fists to him. Subhanallah. So you go and lie against Zuhri, which well established the Imam. But I know where you got this disease from. You go from the Orientalists, from the Musa al-Shriqun. نعم. From the Musa al-Shriqun, who lied against Zuhri, that he used to narrate a hadith in favor of al-Umayyin. So that is a clear, alhamdulillah. Wallahi, that hadith is enough to expose you. Likewise, to again, I repeat my point over and over again. Shia, they will never, ever can bring any clear hadith to support their belief or verses. Do you know what I mean by clear hadith? I mean, even when you look to the context, can see clearly. Sometimes they bring verses and a hadith has nothing to do with the subject. Now, subhanAllah, remind me, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, never Ahl-Bi that bring something from the Quran and Sunnah to support their belief, except we can use it against them. So he tried to use the hadith against us, backfired at him. SubhanAllah. That hadith, first of all, is da'if, even for the sake of argument, it was in a specific event. You know? So I hope, is that clear? SubhanAllah, bihamdik, shadu an la ilaha illa ant. One minute, there's one thing that he said. Shamsi said that Shia leaves the clear hadith and they go to other hadith, and he just did it when he used the other narrations from Najl Balagha. I said it already, I don't really take from your books. But I'm showing you that in your books there's a lot of contradictions. There is, even your scholars mentioned that. There's no narration except go against the other narration. You praise Sahaba, na'am. And again, those who appointed Abu Bakr to be Khalifa, Muhajirun and the Ansar, who Allah praised them in the Quran. So therefore Allah, if you say the Muhajirun Ansar united to appoint Abu Bakr as a Khalifa, and that was they went against the teaching of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. So what Allah would praise? What Allah did praise them in the first place? Now we are proud, as Ali ibn Abi Talib said, I believe that is correct. However, Muhajirun and the Ansar came together and agreed that this person to be Khalifa, that will be pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why we are happy to say Abu Bakr is a Khalifa. Of course, there's a hadith clear cut indication that Abu Bakr is a Khalifa, and that is a different subject, but we suffice with this. Subhanakallah bihamdik, shadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk, wa sallallahu ala imamina wa nabiyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahabati ajma'in, wa sallam salima kathira. Barakallahu fikum.